Hey guys, so I'm going to be trying the Titanic VR experience for you today. So, I know this sounds kind of nerd, but I'm a big Titanic fan. I used to have like posters and stuff. So, I really wanted to try this, and I really hope it's good. It's made by the same people that did the Apollo 11 experience game, or however you want to call it. It wasn't really a game, but there were some gameplay elements. I think this one has more gameplay than the other game. But it's also an experience mode. There's actually a lot of modes. That's pretty cool. I thought it would just be like one thing, but there's a lot of stuff. I don't know what to start with. I guess I'll just start with the experience for now. Oh, and there's two of them. That's pretty cool. Alright, I'll start with the first one. And then I'll try the game. If it's really a game.
Women and children, this way, women and children.
I'm actually kind of scared, Elizabeth.
On the horizon, transfer your passengers and tell their captain to come at once. We require urgent assistance. Surely they can see our rocket, sir. If they can, they are not responding. As quickly as you can.
Aye, aye, sir.
Quickly now, women and children.
Quickly! The boats are leaving!
Daddy, where are we going?
Shh! Oh, this should get me on the lifeboat.
We'll be back soon. Over here. Let's try this one.
We'll head straight for another boat.
Women and children! Final call!
Right.
Yeah,
it's time to go.
No! We must be terrified.
Are they gonna get me on the boat? I'm just gonna stand there. Oh. Oh, nice. I made it.
Bye! Bye, Emily! Bye, Marie!
Daddy!
There, sweetheart. They'll be fine.
Thank you.
My daughter was the same growing up. Father's favorite.
Do you believe there's any real danger?
Oh, no, dear. I saw men locking the watertight doors as I left my cabin. I'm sure we will be back on board soon.
Hey, how do we get to the lifeboats?
Oh dear.
Do the steerage have their own boats?
I don't know. There should be boats in the third class decks, but I haven't seen any.
This boat needs the graphics are pretty cool. It actually kind of looks like you're there.
If you're seaman enough to get onto that boat, you can go.
That looks like a movie more than a game.
Swing over it, that loose rope.
Ready?
Pull! Hurry, damn you!
Where are we heading?
Towards the lights on the horizon. Just off the port bow.
Hold! Put your backs into it!
We can help row.
No! The men will row.
I'm sitting in the weird spot. I'm like on the edge of the boat.
No, you will not. Sit down.
Look, child. Look what I have here. He's friendly. You look.
Oh, I'm scared. I don't want to go.
Would you like to hold him?
I'm that sailor.
And what if there is real danger?
There can't be. The captain said so.
It's actually kind of impressive. I feel really small next to the boat.
This fog on the horizon and no moonlight.
Yes, it's hard to see anything tonight.
I don't see any.
There are a few here.
I'm scared.
Yes, some here too.
It's too dark.
A stowaway!
Oh, officer. Officer, look.
Sorry. So sorry. I can't swim. I...
Coward! Get over there and start rowing.
I can't. I broke my arm. That's why I can't swim. Please, sir. Let me stay. I'm begging you. I don't stand a chance up there.
Sit down, then. You're lucky I haven't thrown you overboard.
The movement will warm us.
I am in charge of this boat. The women are not to row.
Oh, my.
Oh, okay. It's a lantern.
Look at the angle of our ship.
Oh,
but it's unsinkable. Surely?
She'll sink.
The watertight door should keep her afloat.
We only glance the iceberg. Surely she isn't that damaged?
She'll founder. It's just a matter of time.
What about those not in lifeboats?
Able to live with yourself after this.
What about Daddy?
Well, that was sad. It feels weird, like, seeing it like this. Okay, I'm gonna try... Alright, so let's try the game. I'm curious to see how they implemented gameplay in this.
Alright, I've reached the seabed. Can't see much. 500 meters out, and back to manual control. Shall we run an equipment test?
Okay, how does this thing work? Yeah, I guess.
Sure, let's do this by the book.
Alright, let's run through the submersible controls on your wireless controller.
Oh, that's cool, I'm actually moving.
If you hold down
it.
The circle button, a control diagram will appear in front of you. You can operate the submersible using these controls on your controller.
Okay.
You can move the submersible forward, back, left, and right using the left stick. To make the submersible ascend and descend, push up or down on the right stick. The right stick also controls the sub's rotation left and right.
Great. How do I interact with objects?
You can interact with objects
right.
in the submersible
ready, that I'm
by holding
to
down
now.
The L2 button. You can control the movement of the sub's lights by using the up, down, left, and right buttons on your controller. To turn the spotlights on and off, interact with the button in front of the lever.
Will do. Whoa.
Wait, which one is on?
There's something you don't see every day.
She's a beauty.
Okay, where am I supposed to go? Where's the boat? Okay, I guess... Oh, alright. I should go up a little bit, though. Oh, nice. Found it. Oh,
okay.
It's a small, like, shark or fish fry. I don't know what that
is. Interact with the button next to the map to place one.
Yeah.
Marker's been placed.
Okay.
You can head towards the bow. So, I had a call from our main sponsor.
Problem?
No, all fine. Just voicing her excitement about us finally diving. Said she's looking forward to seeing what we can do.
Okay,
I set up the call for 8 p.m. this evening.
For $45,000 a day, let's just hope we find something.
Never mind the money. My doctorate is riding on this.
What do they want me to do? I'm at the target. Oh, do they want me to go down there? No. I passed it. Anyways, I'm gonna go down there. Because I feel like it. Oh, I can't. Oh. Okay, the marker's here, but I'm not sure what I'm supposed to do. Okay, so...
Controls to maneuver the Predator are the same as the submersible. Make your way over to the plaques already laying on the deck, and remember that the range is only up to 15 meters. The advantage of driving without an umbilical.
Is there any way to boost the signal?
Yeah, but we need to upgrade the deep sea transmitter, and they don't come cheap. The generosity of our sponsors and UNS funding only goes so far. If we complete these contract jobs, we might just be able to afford some upgrades.
What happens if I go
that
out of range?
That is really cool and kind of scary.
The automatic recall kicks in. ROV comes straight
just
back to the sub.
Remember what
I said about these new ROVs. The range is only up to 15 meters.
Far. Where am I supposed to go? Forecastle. Can I go down there? No. That is pretty cool.
I'm here.
Oh, there it is.
Great! The plaque we're placing is in the Predator's inventory. You can access it through the menu.
Ah, how do I open the menu? I'll take a photograph with the onboard camera for the Society.
Great idea! They'll appreciate that. Press the cross button to take a photograph. You can get out of camera mode by pressing and releasing the info button again.
Okay. take it?
Yeah, I'll head back to Sedna.
No need. Just press the triangle button on your controller. This is the return button.
Now you're back in the shop.
Oh, I wanted to keep using the robot.
It was,
like,
see
better, it's pretty cool.
Where to now?
Hull breach on E-deck. I'll mark it on your map.
We're heading for his cabin, right?
That's right. Eyewitness testimony said Henderson kept a journal. It should tell us more about his activities on the final night.
I presume I'm looking for some kind of trunk.
Dr. Lynch?
Yeah?
Why are we doing this?
$45,000 a day at sea.
No, I know, but that just about covers the cost of the expedition. I meant, like, why are we taking this job in particular?
Well, put it this way. Why do you think she hired us?
Because we're academics?
Yes, but more specifically, we respect the history. It would have been cheaper for our sponsor to just hire a salvage team.
And why do you agree to take it?
A funny like this comes once in a blue moon, and I wanted to see her up close.
Okay, I'm at the marker. What do I do here? Am I going in there? It's kind of scary.
This breach is from the impact of the
ship
rocket. Anything in here is going to be messy.
I'll keep my eyes peeled.
It's towards the top of the breach. Look for the flashlight.
Can I use the little robot again?
I really hope his briefcase is there.
Oh, nice. Oh, this, yeah. Right. Oh my god. It's almost like a scary game.
Ah, I found a briefcase. I just need to pick it up. WJH. I think this is it.
Well, that's lucky. Are you going to open it?
No, not here. Assuming there's anything intact in there, it'll start degrading.
I don't
want to
go back. I
want
to explore.
We'll have to bring it back to the lab before we can take a peek.
Okay, you should put the briefcase in the creditor's storage then. Just open and close the menu again by pressing and releasing the info button.
That's really cool.
The briefcase will appear in the ROV's inventory as a selectable item, and you'll have your hands free again.
I'm actually scared.
Right. If this is the last task for today, I'll head back to the lab now.
Yep. Just return to the submersible and you can head up from there. I can't wait to see what's inside.
That's really cool. I'm gonna try going upstairs, but I don't think I can go very far. Is that? Can I pick this up? Oh, I took a picture. It actually kind of acts as a flashlight. Oh, I can't go any farther.
Just remember what I said about these new ROVs. The range is only up to 15 meters.
Yeah, this is pretty cool. It looks impressive and somewhat scary. Okay, I'm gonna go back.
Let's get you to the surface. Activate the autopilot and get comfortable.
Okay, what did it say? Return to surface? Already?
Alright, I'll see you in about 2 hours. I'll need to upgrade the transmitter if I want to go any further.
Whoa, looks to be in good condition.
Let's get this cleaned up. Silver doesn't look great after being in the ocean. This tobacco tin is This journal is pretty special. The pages seem to be a fabric paper blend. I think the desalination bath will leach out the salt. Then it can go into the PEG station before freeze drying.
Okay, so I have to pick this up and wash it. How do I move? Okay, it's kind of teleport. Okay. Let's wash this. Get the money, goes in there. And the journal goes in there.
A bone hair comb. I'll need to wash the salt out quickly before it crystallizes and the bone starts to crumble.
Why do you keep dropping it? and the comb there.
It's ready for drying in the acetone bath.
What else? Okay, this goes.
It's come up great.
Treat the money. Not the comb. The comb in acetone. Where is that? No! I keep pressing the wrong button.
Looks like a receipt for a telegraph sent on the night of April 14th.
That's strange. I haven't found any reference to one. Here's our sponsor. We can tell her the news.
Hi, team. How are you both?
Hi, Jillian. We're doing great.
We've just finished cleaning the artifacts we found today. We managed to access Henderson's cabin and retrieve his briefcase.
Wonderful.
Inside, we found his journal, a few personal items still in good condition. One interesting item is a receipt for a telegraph sent on the night of the sinking.
That is interesting. I didn't know William sent a message.
That's what we thought.
It's possible it wasn't sent, and that it's still in either the purser's office or the Marconi room. We're thinking our next dive should be to explore these rooms.
I know teams have searched the Marconi room before, but I didn't think the purser's office was accessible.
Yeah, up till now it's been off limits due to the size of ROVs, but ours is small enough to access it. We're hoping we might find the purser's record book, with the message listed.
As for the Marconi room, other dives have shown most of the furniture is deteriorated, but the telegraph canisters might have survived.
Sounds plausible. Let me know if you find anything. I'd love to see the message he sent. I've only the letters from Southampton.
I noticed something odd in his journal. On the 14th, he mentions carrying some special package, but I'm sure he didn't have anything reported in the manifest. Do you have any idea what it could be?
Well, in his last letter, he wrote about returning home with a present for my great-grandmother. I'll do a bit of research on my end. I can check over the manifest again to see if we missed anything.
Great. We'll let you know if we find anything tomorrow. I'm sending over photos of the items we found today.
Thanks. I really appreciate the regular updates. It's making writing much easier. We'll talk again soon.
Well, shall we call it a day?
Not quite. Jillian was kind enough to order in a stronger transmitter for our ROV. We'll need to fit it before the dive tomorrow. Otherwise, we won't be able to reach the purser's office.
We'll get on it now, then.
It's waiting for you over there.
Thanks.
Where? Here?
I need to replace the transmitter in the ROV with the one on the table next to it. The instructions for replacement are on the posters behind the ROV rack, and I can access the lower sections of the ROV by lifting the rack bar up. She's all ready to go for tomorrow.
Cool. I'll see you in the morning, then.
I don't get it, but okay. It worked, so it's all good now.
Radio check, okay. Wilson.
I can't wait to go inside again.
Great. First up is the purser's office on C-Deck, correct?
Correct. To access it, you'll need to head down through the hole where the forward grand staircase was. I'll mark it on your map.
The C-Deck is pretty compressed from what I've heard.
Nice.
could the seafloor bend most of the supporting pillars, so they're struggling with the weight of the floors above.
With the rate of decay increasing, it won't be long before it all collapses. I'm glad we've had a chance to come down here and see it for ourselves, before all this becomes inaccessible.
Sinking past then, and all of a sudden she lifted up quickly. You could hear everything cracking through her. Everything that was movable was going through her. And then she went down and seemed to come up again. So I thought, well, now I'm going to leave. And I was hanging on to a board. We had two boards, starboard and port, which said, keep clear of propeller blades. And I was hanging on to one of these, and I was getting higher and higher in the air. And I thought, well, now I'll go. And I dropped him. I had a lifeboat on. And I hit the water with a terrific crack. Luckily, I didn't hit anything. I dropped in. The bodies all over the place. And then I looked up at the Titanic. So the propellers were right out of water. The rudder was right out. You could see the bottom. And then gradually she glided away. And that was there. That was the last of the Titanic. I didn't want to die. I mean, I didn't see much chance of living. I was gradually getting frozen.
I'm getting there.
And, by the grace of God,
there
I came across a lifeboat, and they pulled me in.
That's still pretty impressive. Alright, so I guess I have to find an opening to go in. Go through this window. Alright, so the marker is...
You'll need to be careful of debris when descending with the Predator. It might make it easier if you position yourself
right
so the
here.
Lights shine down the void.
Good idea.
I'm nervous. Okay, so we're... Where do I land? Somewhere here. Oh, what's going on? Okay, I'm here. Reach seat deck.
Deploying Predator, starting to descend.
Okay, nice. There's a little jellyfish. Can I touch it? Okay. Can't really. It's so dark. I need a better flashlight. I don't know where I'm going. Oh, that's creepy. Really spooky. So what am I looking for? Reach C deck. Okay. Kinda wanna look around. This way? Did I miss a door or something? Do I have a map? A deck. So I have to find, what was it, C or D? C. That's scary, can I go in there? No, that's naturally. Oh, I'm stuck. Where is it? Kind of scared. Oh, that's cool. You can actually go pretty much everywhere. Wow. That's nice. It's nice and kind of creepy at the same time. Alright, so, back at A deck. I was at the other side of the room. This is creepy. Oh god, that door, like, that's scary. I don't know where I am anymore. It's confusing. Oh, bathroom. That's actually really cool. I didn't think the game would let you explore the ship like this. I think I'm lost now though. I don't know where I went. I'm like really far from where I'm supposed to go. Just turned around. Oh, okay. That's really creepy. Okay, I'm at A deck, so that's not the right place. Can you go, like, faster? Is there, like, a boost? I'm at A, we're probably pretty far from C. This is where I started. Am I supposed to go down, like... Oh, okay, so I guess this is B deck, and I'm supposed to go even farther down.
Here we are.
Scary.
Great. The purser's office and inquiry desk are on the starboard side. You'll need to go over the desk to get into the side room. Go farther down. Whoa, it goes down like really far.
not the right floor, so go back there. Oh crap. Okay. Okay, it's pointing over there.
Right, I'm here.
The office is to the left as you enter. Be careful. This area hasn't been explored before. We don't know what we'll find in here.
To think the last person in this room would have been Chief Purser McElroy.
The record book would have been kept in a leather pouch.
Do we go in there? It's a little crab again. It's kind of cute. Okay, I guess it's over there. What do I do now?
I don't see it here.
Maybe try the safe back out in the inquiry office.
Where? Okay. The doors are rusted shut. We can't check inside.
Is the pouch among the debris?
No, I can't see the leather pouch anywhere. You might be out of luck.
That's a shame.
We'll have to hope the Marconi room gives us some answers.
While we're here, we should collect a sample of the rust on the safe doors. NCPA regularly check for new species of bacteria living
in the
rusticles.
I'll take a photograph of the scene, too. We'll need to see the rusticle formations as well.
Okay.
Done. We'd better move on to the Marconi room.
Do I have a sample?
I'll mark it on your map. You'll need to head back to the sub to get there.
So I have to go back. I don't want to go back to the sub, I want to keep exploring the ship. Kind of scary and interesting at the same time. Oh, there's another jellyfish. How deep down can I go? Oh, I think that's the... Can't go any further from here. I'm actually surprised by everything you can explore. I really didn't think you could explore so much of it. That's really cool. Oh, that just like kind of creeped me out. That I thought I saw like a ghost or something. Okay, I'm gonna go back to the sub. I'm getting kind of nervous and scared.
The Marconi room isn't too far.
Even though I know nothing will happen, it's not a scary game, but still.
How do I get in?
Either through the skylight or the corridors. Up to you, which you feel is safer.
Right, I don't want to damage the wreck, or the ROV.
Okay, I'm here. Why doesn't he want to go? Enter the Marconi room. Okay. Oh, why am I back here? I don't think I'm supposed to be here again. I think I pressed the wrong button, I don't know. I should be able to just get off the submarine like somewhere around here. I don't know why it's not working. Oh well, anyways, I'm gonna try the other modes and I'll come back to this later. I hope it's safe, my game. But yeah, it's pretty cool. Alright, so I've tried a little bit of everything except the sandbox. I didn't figure out what it was for exactly yet. But yeah, so everything was pretty cool. The experience was nice. It was really impressive to actually be there. And the game is a lot more than I expected. I thought it was just going to be like a short experience, kind of like Apple 11, but it was actually an actual game. Sorry, I don't know why I keep saying actually, but I've just looked at the level select, and a lot of levels, if you can see. I wish you could just choose one of them and go. I want to try the ghost. But yeah, so it's it seems like it's pretty long. It would take a while to finish, I guess. But yeah, I really liked this. It was more than I expected, a lot more. So it was pretty interesting, pretty cool, and kind of scary. Even though it's not supposed to be scary, but it's just so impressive, I guess. It makes it kind of scary in the atmosphere and everything. So I would definitely recommend this if you wanna look around the Titanic. If you're a fan like me, it's a pretty cool thing to try out. So thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this.